No, right now? Could you just jump on the... Okay.
Fixing it right now.
Just fixing it. Fixing.
You guys did mention the colors, too, but Jenny Hansen did
all the color work
for this, and her concentration at the Academy, I think, was all on pastel backgrounds or something, so...
She's
this
incredible.
Was a perfect match.
Doing the colors in this show. For her.
Yeah, she used to tell me it was a unique challenge with the show because a lot of the stuff was transparent, so you couldn't just pick a solid color and know it was going to work. You had to see how it was going to look when it got transparentized.
What Lippy's talking about is we have a sort of paper texture.
Please tell him what the hell I'm talking about.
Behind on the background. I don't know if you noticed the background. It's a little lighter than everything else, and it's got a weird paper texture on it, which makes kind of coloring the background a little hard because it's never what you had to
compensate.
Now, this episode was huge. There were so many characters in this episode. I remember that it was just like, we didn't think it was going to happen because it was just too much going on.
This is a lot of fun. It's an epic race inspired by the Wacky Races from Hanna-Barbera.
We wanted to introduce Lifty and Shifty as the Kleptomaniac brothers at home.
Yeah.
Who aren't watching.
Faces were
who
grinding.
Who ran to get a sandwich. Their faces grinded against the ground.
Lots of blood. We like the blood. Yeah. We spread it liberally.
This show is actually created to fill the void of... TV violence.
That's so...
Yeah, there really is... I think since the early 20s, there hasn't been enough TV violence.
This next one is true.
You owe him money.
This is a lot. Pitching Impossible. This the is mole. Our... The Mole intro. Our blind mole character, who never really lived up to what we wanted him to be.
Oh, the opening shot here. He turns around.
Maybe if we sell enough DVDs, we could...
Yes, maybe. More.
If you tell your friends about this, and you know, it's a great gift. It's Christmas right around the corner.
Small, portable, easily wrapped. Everybody loves it. It's got everything for everybody, really.
But we're gonna have more episodes of the Mole. We had come up with all these things where he was like a secret agent, super spy type, you know, like a James Bond or somebody out of Mission Impossible, where he had all these gadgets and he sort of stumbled through. These like incredible missions,
Mr. Magoo style,
with like rocket launchers and things like that were going on around him. It was just crazy.
This was the actual Jason Sadler first animation thing here, right?
Yeah, look at those people fly.
I think the first one was Pop and Cub, but
a little misinformation there for you folks.
Brody's just trying to confuse everybody.
Some fat guy in Toronto almost sent the wrong email. But then thank God you guys corrected him.
Yeah, he was on the internet quickly. He was about to hit that send button. Set!
Oh, thank God I listened to the full transmission.
This next one is Staying Alive, which is the dreaded Disco Bear episode.
Yeah, this was one that
I love this episode.
Thanks, Lippy.
Oh, yeah. Dear.
Here's $20.
For those of you who couldn't see at home, Lippy got down and kissed Rhodey's butt.
Actually, I was about to kiss Jason because I remember the animation on this when we do. Well, I won't spoil it.
This was tough to pitch to the
everybody.
Team here. Everybody, they didn't like Disco Bear.
Voiced by Peter Herman.
Yeah, Peter Herman. He was amazing.
Yeah, he was good.
Oh, the voice is good, but
yeah,
not Disco Bear.
Peter did great.
So it was a lot of fun doing the split screen stuff with him, 70s style. But most of the team didn't like this character, so I just thought it'd be great, even if he were just a one-hit wonder, to show up at least in one episode. And sure enough...
You thought it was a hit.
that's a hit, but it's more of a wonder how it showed up in an episode.
I liked him.
I remember we kind of struggled with how Disco Bear would either... hurt these animals or get hurt himself. Then we realized that he probably, even though we all wanted to kill Disco Bear, that we decided
that come on, the robot. Look at the robot.
Hey, it's the best.
Give it up for the robot.
It's actually Stefan Gustafsson animated the robot.
That's right. Another animator
who worked on the show.
Wow. We had thousands of animators on this show. I don't know how everybody remembers all these guys.
Oh, just a little note in that little iris. We have that. I don't know how we started that iris, but we did it in Spin Fun, and we just
kept it
for all the episodes.
We thought
every episode,
funny, yeah,
iris out, iris is out on something. Little punch up.
Which one's this one?
This should be
Treasure Idle Moments.
One of the classics.
Oh, you can talk about the xylophone thing that you always do at the end. Like the sound.
That's how Ken would pitch it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Jim Lively actually does that with his mouth.
That's great. This is our tribute to the bringing up the idol, making it its own.
Yeah, it's a cursed really idol. The idol.
Actually, to avoid the lawyers on this is actually in Indiana Jones, but it's based on a Mayan artifact.
Ooh. Oh.
There's the idol, the cursed idol.
Rody's throwing shout outs to the
Brady Bunch idol, dude. It's a Brady Bunch idol.
I want to make shout out to the Mayans.
If anyone out there is a Brady Bunch person, or knows a Brady Bunch person, I'd sue these bastards.
It's...
The Hawaiian...
Here's a great point of view shot.
There's Lumpy in his business outfit. Don't ask us where he went.
There's the idol with a seatbelt, by the way. We wanted to make sure.
Safety first.
Safety first, kids.
So that was the best stuff ever happening off screen.
What was the catch line at the end of that one? What was the little...
Buckle up for safety.
Buckle up.
Yeah, of course. That would be the best.
That's our little...
Oh, no.
What is it? I didn't see.
Did wipe ever make it? Oops. Wipe.
Wipe.
I just always thought.
Wipe three times.
Oh, wipe for safety. Wipe.
Don't forget.
Wipe three times.
This is a pop and cup episode.
Chip off the old block.
Oh, there's another Kenism when the characters pop their heads up and just chomp down. Oh, yeah.
Oh,
love it.
Doinkimation.
He spent hours with those chomps.
This was one of those episodes that went through a couple of different iterations.
Just because Cub is so obviously a little kid.
This episode is filled with controversy.
Yeah. You'll see on the right side where the original boards are in the end.
But this is the cringe factor, though. This is it right here.
Yeah, this is the
something bad's gonna happen, and it's just like, but we didn't. But it was so obvious that we couldn't let it happen. So it was like one of those things where it was like kind of toying with the audience. Because like people after this episode, I mean, after a while, people got to realize, okay, they're going to get hurt. But we wanted to kind of play with it.
The old bait and switch again.
Bait and switch.
Aubrey Ankrum as Pop again. Yeah. Doing a fine job as a dad.
Who was Cub?
Only Dana. In real life, not so good. So
real life, not a good dad.
So here's where it starts.
So this is where it starts getting controversial. So you're just taking out this kid. You know, which is a good death.
Eyeball.
Great death.
Fun.
Defamation.
Yeah, and then he falls into the leaves. And then.
Oh, no.
If you see. Yeah. Is it on the right
side? On the right side, yes. The original ending was it fades to black, and you see him. Right? You see.
Wait for it. Wait for it.
There it is.
He lights his. Yeah, you see the. On the right side. The burning leaves. Like, it's implied that he burned his son, which was hard to swallow for a lot of people. It was too morbid.
A lot of the mucky mucks.
People forget it's a cartoon. It's a cartoon.
It ain't real.
No cartoon animals were harmed during any of this.
Well, a couple
except
were.
For, yeah.
But they deserved it. They deserved it. They were stupid, you know? Safety first. That's what we.
Actually, we could talk a little bit about the opening song. Is we just it was loosely based on the Three Stooges credits run, and we actually just went in the sound room and freestyled a lot of
doos, la-las, and RJ putting it together.
Excellent job of composing the piece.
Basically, we told him we wanted something really cute
and
really annoying.
Yeah,
and that was it. It was great.
I think it was number 2 on the top 10 for a while.
It was for a while in the UK charts.
In the UK, yeah.
RJ did all the music for all the episodes too, right?
Yeah, he scored all the episodes.
Yeah,
great.
Yeah, so Dennis, that kind of speaks for itself, just in the fact that that's cringe. Cringe factor.
We always knew Dentist was trouble.
When you guys put me in the sound room, I remember this episode because you had intricate instructions for every single pain and gag that was going to happen. And they're all, you know, it's all the same. I'm just going,
and be like, no. More pain.
No, yeah. No. Lower jaw pain, not upper.
The battery's stopping lip. We're going to have to trail the screen.
Think back.
This was one of those, again, another episode which had three different endings, actually. You'll see right now is the ending that, third ending that we went with, and you'll see on the boards on the right. We planned it, and this next one is the second ending.
Oh, that was my fave.
I like how Lumpy shaving in this one.
This was the original ending, actually. Excuse me. This was the golf ending where Toothy.
Oh,
no, this was the second one. Yeah. Golf was second.
Look, it showed.
No, this was the first one.
We never showed the golf one, did we?
No,
no.
We never showed it. Did you even animate
it? It's on the board.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah, we showed it on the board. Whoops. Yeah, cut that out.
This last one is the. Oh no, this was the original ending, I think. Was the carjack ending.
That's what I said.
People just thought it was too weird. I liked it.
Now, kids.
Oh yeah, the carjack one. You were all excited about that one.
I like that ending.
That's where he sticks the carjack in his mouth and he rips his head off.
Oh yeah, that there is was a good one.
Controversy about reading the book and not.
You guys cut that one out. Yeah. Oh, you're fools.
Who animated that with his mouth open? Like a mouth stayed open as he was panting.
Who animated that?
Nice.
I did.
Kevin Costner. That was me. Kevin Costner?
Might have been Stefan or any of those guys.
Hide and seek.
This episode has a special guest appearance by Sylvester Stallone. You gotta watch for it.
No.
No, this was a controversial character, Flippy, right there.
Flippy.
Oh,
voice
I
by
love Flippy.
Yeah, no, we had long. We would talk about all the things Flippy could do. It would be like
Flippy was the war vet. And he would have flashbacks, post-traumatic stress syndromes that were triggered by the smallest things.
Like Rambo.
Yeah, we had one where it was just one we talked about. Was like he'd go to a birthday party and the balloon would pop and he'd start freaking out. And it would get all John Woo and stuff, and he'd like flip over the table in slow motion and with double fist in hand, because he'd go boom, 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 boom.
Yeah, he's just taking out the Happy Tree Friends, which is the problem
that people had.
Again, more controversy with Happy Tree Friends.
Okay, here comes Sylvester Stallone, right?
Wait,
right here. Did you see it on that cut? It's quick. I mean, either you can catch it or you don't.
Get the DVD. You can see it in the DVD. Yeah.
Slow it down and pause it. You can watch.
Yeah, this is the... This is Tiger Pit. And this is one that I always... The hand.
Yeah, still bugging.
The opposable joints.
Flip it over.
Wait, his hand.
Double jointed fingers.
Yeah.
Double jointed's fun. It's good.
It's good times for double jointed.
It's good times.
And no one else who caused deliberate pain but Flippy. Flippy was the only one that...
Flippy, as far as characters,
deliberately
hurt
inflicted people. Pain,
just fun.
And that was his thing.
Well, there you go. Hope you enjoyed the commentary, and
come back soon. Visit us some other day.
Yeah.
Buy more DVDs.
We love you.
That's sad.